So basically I'm now going to talk about myself, and it's actually a series of discussion which I went to Orissa for mobilizing to the Chalo Delhi program. So basically I went there to mobilize students to come to Delhi, but after going there, the kind of casteist oppression they are facing there, when I saw, like, I didn't really like find the courage to ask them to come to Delhi, because they have to firstly fight for themselves there, and the kind of blatant casteist oppression they are facing there is more like oppressive from here, and that is more, I mean, open in nature. So I am going to narrate some of these incidents. So first of all, if we talk about institutional discrimination, the colleges I went in, are most of them are in Western Orissa. So this fellowship problem is, you know, it's all over India. Like most of these fellowship programs are monthly fellowship programs, but they got only in 1 year. So the Dalit students who comes from very economically poor background, they need the fellowship monthly to like for their expenditure, or whether to like fund for admission or any like form fill out, anything. But they got it in the end of the year only. So the basic problem is there is no any like institutional mechanism to solve these problems. Here basically we can at least go to the student union or to the fellowship department to talk about this, but there is complete absence of any mechanism through which they can solve their demands. Second is this very, I mean, peculiar problem I think in Orissa is there are separate hostel for STHC students in almost all colleges. So when I was studying in Orissa, I thought, and some of my friends, we had this feeling that because these SCST hostels, they were like taking few money than the general or the unreserved category hostel, it is better for them. But when I went this time and talked to these students, the problem is like when the selection is made for the hostels, what they do is if the selection process for this general hostel is something around 60% marks, so what they do is they don't take into account the SCST students who have more than 60% marks, and they usually fill the general hostels with only general students, and they take only 1-2 students from STST category to show that they are inclusive. And in this SCST hostel, what they do is they took all these students with 80% marks, 90% marks, and put them in the SCST hostels, and all the remaining SCST students, they have to live outside with their own cost, like, which is very difficult for them to pay. Again, when I went to a hostel, I saw a Saraswati Puja pendal outside the hostel, and the hostel was meant for STHC students only. So when I was studying there, I never saw like this kind of festival organized there. So I asked them like why, like when I went, actually they were all very vocal about the caste discrimination in educational institutions. So like I didn't understand why they are doing Saraswati Puja, so I asked them. So the answer they give was like, when last year they didn't celebrate Saraswati Puja, and most of them are SCST students when they are from this Christianity background, so they usually eat beef. So the ABBP people came and threatened that you all SCST people, you are not doing any like, what you know that. They threaten them to celebrate Saraswati Puja, otherwise they threaten them for physical violence. So this year, to avoid the physical violence, they celebrated Saraswati Puja. So, and you know, they have no mechanism to address such kind of issue, and they cannot do anything like that. And in one city, we organized a protest regarding Rohith Bhimula issue. So there I was asked not to raise slogans against Modi. Like generally in HCU, if we say Modi Murdabad, then it's not a big threat to us. But in Sambalpur, when I raised the slogan, people suddenly came in me and like they told me that not to raise such kind of slogans. And the kind of behavior the teachers are showing there is also very problematic. For example, when SCST students get any clear the NET exam, this was one of my friends, he was explaining to me that when he cleared NET exam and he told to his supervisor and told that I cleared NET, so he told that yeah, your SCST is easy to get. Then he actually, after clearing JRF also, he went there to him and he told him. So again he told that like, it happens, SCST students generally gets JRF. So the kind of answers actually demoralize the students very much. And there are many personal narratives which I don't want to go to. So like this I want to conclude, and you can understand the kind of situation there, and I don't know how they are going to fight with all these kind of problems, because there is no such like mobilization or platform to actually raise the issue.